Lights are on, and we're rolling. A slow start for Nemo as Smoggy takes the lead.
Welcome to the world of marble racing, where small glass spheres take the driver's seat, careening and colliding toward the finish line.
To me, it is definitely a sport. It has so many of the central tenets of what we think of as sports. If you can get past the suspension of disbelief that it's marbles, it still has underdogs and come-from-behind wins and upsets and all of these great things that we usually put so much emotion into in human sports.
Orange, a nice little dive bomb move on Anarchy.
Iowa native Greg Woods announces the action of the Marble League, launched in 2016 by brothers Jelle and Dion Bakker in the Netherlands. This February, Marbula One, a Formula One racing-inspired tournament, debuted, seeing a burst in popularity from fans craving competition.
I think that is in part what makes this such an escape, which is very pertinent for the situation that we're in right now, is that this is a different world that overall is pretty good-natured and pretty lighthearted, but taken with this air of seriousness, and it makes it really easy for people to have that suspension of disbelief and really get into it.
Those are prime seats right there.
The marbles have individual names and play for teams like the Raspberry Racers and Green Ducks.
Good launch off the corner by Savage Speeders, but they hit the attenuator of the pit lane.
There are big fan bases built up, not just for the teams, but for the individual marbles. And when one isn't performing very well in the season, you're going to hear about it on there. And they will, you know, let that marble know. They got to pick up their game a little bit.
20,000 people from around the world tuned in live to watch last week's race. And Jelle's Marble Runs YouTube channel has millions of views. So will marble mania continue when the sports shutdown ends?
When we do get sports back, when, you know, the Blackhawks are playing again and everything else is back to normal, I'm going to love that. But at the same time, we're going to keep going, and hopefully some of those fans will stick with us even when the sports vacuum is gone.
Around the final turn, it will be Team Galactic getting the win.
Josh Friedman, WGN News.